Again, we want to thank Selkirk for being the sponsor of today's clinic. We're going to go over first today, when you're stuck in the midcourt, what you can do to help get yourself out of this. We're going to demonstrate some of the things, then we're going to go out and we're going to drill it. We'll have the coaches come around with you and help you figure out what you can do, how you can improve with this. I'll both of you on that side. So there's been many times, every one of us, we've hit a bat drop shot. We've come in part way and we realize, I am in trouble. What am I going to do? You know, that's typically what happens is we get in trouble. Midcourt ball, we hit it, and it just flubs and the point's over because we got part way in, but we didn't get all the way in. So it might be because we drove a ball. You know, we hit it hard. Let me try that again, Corey. Sorry. One more time. So I've hit a ball hard, and I'm stuck here in the midcourt. I've got to be able to do something. Obviously, it's not going to be an offensive shot. It should be a defensive shot. What happens is we typically panic, and we swing hard. The worst thing you can do when you're in the midcourt is to take a ball and hit it hard back at your opponent. Because if I'm here and he's hit a ball to me, and I come here like this. So he's hit a ball to me here at midcourt, and I hit it hard.
Still too good.
I want you to hit it back at my feet. We didn't rehearse this very well. Okay. So if I hit a ball to him and I hit it hard, I don't have time to advance to get in further. So my goal is to. So if I hit it. Sorry. Again, midcourt's where you're in trouble. We'll get it right here. So if I hit a ball midcourt and I hit it hard back at them, I can't get in any further and I'm going to be in trouble. So instead of trying to just swing away, you know, at this ball here, I really want every one of us to learn to block or to drop this ball. Thanks, coach. So as I'm here, either I can volley it or I can get it after it has bounced. But I want to just, and you're not going to be perfect with it, you're not going to get every ball in, but I don't want to swing away. I'm not going to be able to advance up to the kitchen line. Most likely if I've swung away, that ball is going to stay at this level, and they're going to be able to hit the ball back at me more aggressively than the last ball was. I'm going to accelerate a point when I'm at the disadvantage. I want to decelerate a point from this spot. So it'll look like this. I want to just drop it in there and then slowly try to get one more step in. You know, and they feel you coming in. That was a perfect example, Corey. As they feel me taking that step in, they think, oh, I've got to hit that ball lower. Instead of me driving it, I'm making it a style and a speed that I want. So again, I've hit a ball, I'm in trouble right here. I'm just gonna clip it up, and I'm gonna keep clipping until I've been able to get my way in all the way to the net. So it takes practice. Again, right here, so hit it at my feet. That was good what you just did. When I have this ball at my feet, I have to sometimes short hop it. So you have to really keep your eye on that ball when you're short hopping it, because if not, you're gonna hit it in the net. Again, that's what we see quite a bit of the time, is a ball gets deep on a person, they hit it, and they just do this, and they don't go anywhere with it. So you have to learn to both catch it out of the air and dive the ball, and after it has bounced. So, go ahead and start it. So I've hit a shot, I'm in trouble, hit one that I'm going to volley. So right there, I'm going to hit it in the air. Yeah, it wasn't great, but I stayed in the point. So I'm going to volley it, I'm going to stay in the point until I finally feel like, okay, now I can take my step in and I'm into the point like this. So it doesn't have to be the first. It doesn't have to be the second. You're just trying to neutralize a point, not let it get sped up. Your goal is to not let them catch a ball in the air, but rather make that ball land in the kitchen. So when you're here, you know, like this, and that was Corey, what he was trying to show earlier, is you feel, uh-oh, I'm in trouble. I know I'm not supposed to be here. So you swing hard. You're out of control. They have control of the point. You want to just say, hey, I'm okay. I'm comfortable being here. Slow that ball down. Slowly make your way in. The second thing, I mean, there are times if I'm rescuing a ball, let's say I'm just coming across, I'm going to hit it. I hit that wrong. There are times you have to hit it hard, but you're not going to advance. If I hit it hard, I'm going to still stay here and wait until I can slow it down. Don't feel like, okay, I know I'm in the wrong place, so I'm just going to immediately rush to the net, even when I've hit a poor, you know, I've driven the ball. Obviously, and again, you don't have to get every step in. Sometimes you get one step, then you get another step, and you just work your way all the way up. Keys, watch that ball the whole way. I can't be doing this. Okay, well, I shouldn't be able to do that. I should, you know, my head's got to be on that ball. As I hit it, I'm right here the whole time, catching it out in front of me. Don't let those balls get deep. Again, when a ball has gotten past you, you're not going to hit a good shot with that. You can't hit even to your body. So hit one where it goes deep to me. If it's gone deep on me, I am probably going to rescue it with a lob. That's the shot that you're probably going to have the best opportunity with. Thank you. So, mid-court shots, first off, don't panic. You can hit a good controlled ball. Don't overswing. Don't swing hard. Keep your eye on the ball. Block it. Whether you're catching it out of the air and you're volleying it, or whether you're short hopping and catching it, get as low as you can. The lower you are, if I'm hitting a ball like this, I'm not going to have control with it. You want to get down. As you've gotten in trouble, you're here in a good ready position. You can lean from here to here. You can get your whole half of your court covered with that. As a side note, not really with mid-court being caught, but one of the worst things that can happen is, Coach, jump out here with me. I hit a bad shot. My partner, you just run up to the line all the way. He's now up there all the way. They see that I'm back. I'm in huge trouble right here. It's one of the both pressure for my partner. When you're this guy here, if your partner's got stuck in mid-court, stay with him in mid-court, because when we're split like this, they have seams all over the place. And it puts that much more pressure on me, because I say, oh, my partner's up there. If I hit a bad shot, go up there. I hit a bad shot, they're going to tomahawk it and hit it right at his head.
Not really. In a real game, I might. But
in reality, you don't want to put that extra pressure on your partner. If your partner's only made it up halfway, you guys are going to fight from midcourt and work up. Don't be uneven. So that's not really today's topic, but that's just a side note with that. Again, when you're trying to increase your room for making an error, so if I'm in trouble right here, mid-court, if I hit a ball at an angle, so I have a lot more room to make an error if I go wide than if I go straight forward. If I go straight forward, I have to hit it just perfectly to Kale, and I might get it too high. Or I do the same thing with, I'm going to hit it to you, Kale, now I'll hit over to Corey. When I hit this one to Kale, I can have the angle to go over, and one more ball, thank you. I can have the angle to hit it here, and I have a lot more room because you're not just hitting to these 7 feet, but when I go at this angle, I have more like 12 feet that I'm trying to hit that ball into. So there's using angles when you're in trouble, any place on the court. You know, if someone has put me in a bad spot here, I want to use the angle because I have more room to hit the distance of the shot. So. Don't get caught in just always hitting straight forward. Work on going with an angle. So I think that's the general idea of what we're going to try. We want to go out and have everybody drill this, and we're going to come around and watch you in mid-court and see if we can help give you some tips, see if you're doing it right. So how our drill is going to be is we're going to have one person stand at mid-court. We'll start with that far side is going to be at the kitchen line. They're going to hit balls into the feet, and you're going to just hit two or three shots. Don't even move on your first one. You have to hit two or three, and then try to work your way in all the way to the kitchen, and then start over. And we'll have each side do it a couple times as we come around and observe what you're doing. But again, remember, you're not swinging hard for midcourt. You're going to block, volley, or on a ground stroke, and possibly dink it. You know, if it's just like a long dink from here. If it's an easy ball. If it's a harder, more sped up ball, you really just want to block it. We're working on pace with this. So we're going to use, it looks like, these closest four courts. We'll use this court, and then if we need to, we'll use that next set. Four people per court, and then we'll come back here and review it afterwards. Yes, questions?
I'm merely new, so how does your movement work? Like
That's a great question. You want to have as little movement as possible through your wrist. You almost like when you're putting, when you're golfing, you want to be very, very clean, very, very little movement at the paddle itself. So you're not going to hit topspin. You're not going to try to crank a ball from here. Show us what not to do. Yeah, because you're going to have a lot less control with that. Great shot, Kale.
Not those two.
But the goal is, because you're trying to slow the pace down, I want slow pace, not hard.
It's hard to do that. Super hard to take a big swing.
You're going to miss, you're going to have a lot more errors with that. So on dinking, again, but the number one thing is to catch the ball out front. So I'm going to look like this, I'm going to look like this, I'm going to look like this. I'm not going to look like this, this, this. I want everything here. Even if I'm catching it at an awkward height, I still want to catch it out front. Thank you. Good question. Does that make sense?
And I think also the question is not moving. When you you're stopped. You're not running and blocking. You're stopped.
So it's not a lot of movement. Right. Arm motion here, but everything's...
And your feet are stopped as well, so you can boom, get in.
You're going to use the pace of the ball that's coming at you, and you're going to try to slow that pace down. You're not trying to make it go fast at all, so you shouldn't have a lot of shoulder. You shouldn't have a lot of, you know, quick movements with your paddle or your arm. Any other questions before we head out to the courts? All right, let's fill all these courts up and we'll come around.